Okay. So in the URL rewriting, what we do in general is just we add this request parameters to the URL. How the URL is, the first servlet, the control transfers from login servlet to first servlet through this URL, hello.first. Okay. What we do is we send these values. There are two usernames, Ravi. Understand what we do? Okay, just we send the values, or we send the values that are supposed to be maintained in the session through URL, through the query string, in the form of query string. Okay, so by default the URL will be like this, hello.first. But what we are doing is we are developing the URL in such a way that, okay, just the request parameters will be added as a query string. Okay. These values, the values that we enter in login.html, username and password, will be submitted to login servlet. From login servlet to first servlet, by default only first name and last name will be submitted. But in addition to them, we are adding username and password as query string. Okay? Understood? So, in the same way, from first servlet to second servlet, we submit the form using the URL. But in addition to them, we submit the form using this URL. Okay? Just see here. From first servlet to second servlet, we submit the form using this URL. But in addition to that, we add username, password values. So, how many request parameters will be submitted here? 2 request parameters through form and 4 request parameters through URL. Request parameters can be submitted to the server side in 2 ways, either through URL or form. Earlier, all the request parameters were submitted through form fields, okay? Some hidden fields, some visible fields. But now, the values that are supposed to be maintained in the session are being submitted as URL, query string in the URL. The visible field submitted will be submitted as form fields. Understood the difference? Understood? Earlier we used to submit these values as hidden form fields, but now we submit these values as query string. That's it. The rest of the concept is the same. Okay? Accessing the values that we have entered in the first page in like accessing the values of one request in another request is something like session management. Okay? That session management can be achieved through hidden form fields or in some other approaches. Either through hidden form fields or through URL rewriting, or in any other approach we can achieve this session management. Okay? And we shall discuss. Understood the concept, right? How URL rewriting will work? Just what we do is, from login servlet to first servlet, we get username and password values. But that values will not be available when we submit the form from login.html to login servlet, we submit username and password. But that will not be available by default when we submit the request from login servlet to first servlet. But what we do is, to maintain them, okay, to make them available, to make those values available, what we do is, earlier we used to add them as hidden form fields. Now, we add them or we append them to the URL itself. We append those values. We append those request parameters and values to the URL as a query string. That we call, by default the URL is By default, the URL is hello.first. But we are rewriting the URL to contain some parameters and values, okay, which are supposed to be maintained in the session. Earlier, we used to add them as hidden parameters. The only thing is, now we are not maintaining the session through hidden parameters. We are rewriting the URL so that that values will go in that request. Understood? So let's do the same. Understood how session is maintained in, sorry, how session is, will be maintained using URL rewriting? Just earlier we used to do the same thing using hidden parameters. Now we are not using hidden parameters. The same thing will be achieved by appending the query string to URL. Understood? So now from login servlet, what we do is, now this URL should not be submitted. The URL which is appended with username and password values will be submitted. Okay, so let me write this logic here, the same logic. So what we do is, by default the URL will be hello.first. Okay, we keep a question mark. That question mark will be the, okay, delimiter between the request parameters that we submit and the URL. Okay, so just we use a string buffer, just because when we change the content frequently, when we change the string content frequently, we use a string buffer. When we change the string content very frequently, then we use a string buffer. Just because this URL content is changing, just because we add request parameters and their values. So if there are 10 request parameters, then this string content will change 10 times. So if the string content is frequently changing, then we use string buffer. Okay, so what we do is, just observe what I'm doing. So by default the URL will be, so let me explain this logic. So By default, the URL will be hello.first. So the URL value is hello.first question mark. And then in the first iteration, what happens? Param values, the parameter name is username, okay, and the parameter values are Ravi and, okay, so by default the URL is hello.first, okay. And then what we are doing is we are iterating each and every parameter value. What is the parameter value here? What is the size of this param values array? 2, just because there are 2 values, okay. Understood? There are 2 values, so the size of this param values array is the entry value is 2. So now what happens is URL.append of string buffer will append the string content at the end. So now the URL value will become hello. We are appending the key of the entry. What is the key of this entry? Username. So username, and then we are appending equal to, and again we are appending the param value. What is the first value? Ravi. Okay, ampersand, okay. Then again, what is the size of this? How many times this for loop will be iterated?
Twice,
just because once for Ravi and second is for Rajesh. So ampersand, again we are appending the same, okay. URL.append, entry.get key. What is the key? Username, okay, and the value equal to, and the value. Now the value is second iteration, the value is Rajesh. Again ampersand. Again, the second key value pair or the second entry is password entry, whose value is 123. Okay, so now what is the size of this array in the second entry for the second request parameter? 1. The size of this array is 1. So again, so the same URL. What is, how many times this for loop will be iterated? Only once, just because there is only one value for password. So ampersand, what is the key here now? The key is password. Understood? The key is password. Again equal to param value. What is the value? 123. Okay, 123. Ampersand. This is what the URL is generated. So now how the values are going means, earlier these values used to go through hidden form fields. Now the values are going through query string, through the URL rewriting mechanism. Understood? How this will be? Yes? Now we develop the same logic even in the first select. Now this map should be here, just because we are using this map before, okay. Now we submit the form. Now no, the action should not be hello.first. The action should be in single quotes the URL. But Is there any problem in this URL? Just observe this URL that we have developed. Is there any mistake in this URL? Is it a proper URL or is there any mistake? The HTTP or the HTTP? Just think only about the query still. The URL mapping doesn't check for the query string. The URL pattern will just check for the URL. This is the URL and this is the query string. The URL pattern, okay, of the web server will be verified only against the URL, not the query string. Okay? See, I am not asking advantages, disadvantages. There is some problem in this URL, this query string. There is some mistake in this query string. Just see. See, please observe here the URL question mark parameter name equal to parameter value ampersand parameter name equal to parameter value ampersand parameter name equal to parameter value ampersand. After ampersand, is something there? No. If after ampersand, if nothing is there, then what is the use of this ampersand? Okay, it's not required. So at the end, what we do is there is a method delete caret. Understood what we have done? If you know string and string buffer, you can understand better. Understood this statement? What we have done? Or what it will do? Understood? What it is doing? What it is doing? What this statement will do? Index of method will expect an integer, will expect an index or will return an index. Index of method will return an index of the input string. Last index of method will return the last occurrence. Index of the last occurrence of that string. What is the last occurrence of ampersand in this string? See, what we do is we execute something like this. Now our actual string is this. Okay, we execute this code. First this code is executed. Okay, you are in not last index of ampersand. What last index of method of string will do means, it will fetch the last or index of last occurrence of that string. Leave over the first part. The second part is last occurrence of the string. What is the last occurrence of ampersand? In this string, this is the last occurrence of ampersand. Okay? This is the last occurrence of that ampersand. Okay? Index of, last index of what it will do? It will give the index of last occurrence of that string. Now in the string, what is it given? Ampersand. So last index of will give the index of last occurrence of ampersand. This is the last occurrence of ampersand. Let's consider like this index is some 52. Let's consider like this. So we are deleting the character at 52nd index. So internally what it will do? It will delete. Let's consider like this is a character whose index is 52. So it will remove the character at that specific index. Now is it a perfect URL then? Is it a perfect URL now? Yes or no? Yes. Okay. So we'll write this code just to remove the last ampersand. Okay. So we write the same logic even in the other servlets also. We write the same logic even in the first servlet also. Okay, I'm not changing anything. Just I'm writing the same logic even in the first servlet. I am copying the logic and I am pasting it in the first cell. So not writing any big logic, just I am copying and pasting the same thing. Okay. And then this logic is not required. Logic of hidden functions is not required now. So understood what we have done? Understood? So what we have done is just we have created a URL, by default the URL value pattern will be pointing to the first servlet. And to that URL, we are appending the request parameters and their values. And at the end, we are removing the last ampersand. And we are maintaining that as a URL. Understood? Understood? So let me try to compile this and execute the application. Press compile. Let me execute that. Now, so if we submit here, it will go to login servlet. In login servlet, if we enter the values, okay, and go next. the username and password values of the earlier requests were being submitted through the URL. Okay, so we have rewritten. By default, the URL is only this. By default, the URL is this. Okay, but we have rewritten the URL so that it contains even the query string, which contains the report. But earlier, these values were submitted through return form fields. Now, through query string. That's it. Now, so last name, username, username, first name, password. Okay, sorry, it has submitted to the first server just because we have given the URL pattern as first server. From the first server, we are submitting to the same server. So let me give second. From the first server, here we are submitting to the same first server. Let me stop the server. Compile, restart. We go to login page. From login page, let me give the values. Submit. Let me give the first name and last name. Go. See, username and password fields are submitted here. Again. Submit the values. So last name is there, username is there, two usernames, Ravi Rajesh, are submitted, and email ID is there, first name is there, password is there, mobile, everything is there. But all those values are submitted, okay, to the target servlet or to the second servlet as a query string. So by default, the URL is this, but we have overridden the URL in such a way that, okay, the values to be maintained in the session will go as query string. Okay, will go as request parameters through query string. Earlier, request parameters through hidden form fields. Now those request parameters are going through query string. If it is done by the server, but we are doing it ourselves, right? Understand? We are doing it ourselves. Since we are doing it ourselves, okay, that will be appended. But the web server will not append the form fields to the URL if it is post. Understand? The web server will not append the form fields to the URL as a query string if the method is post. But what we are doing? We are appending the URLs in the servlet logic to the URL by URL rewriting. We are appending that query string in the servlet. Okay, that is our logic. Using our logic, we can do anything. But what the web server will do means, web server will not append this request parameters as a query string. Okay, if the method is post. Okay, but in the servlet logic, we can do that. Now, the advantage of URL rewriting is it's pretty much simple when compared to hidden form fields. Generating or maintaining the values in the session is pretty much simple when compared to hidden form fields. Okay, but the disadvantage is everything will be displayed in the browser address bar. Okay, and one more disadvantage is there are many values. Okay, it will reach the limit of maximum URL length. Let's consider the maximum URL length is 5000 characters. It may hit the maximum URL length if the number of parameters are more. Okay? If the number of parameters are more, it may hit the maximum URL length. That are disadvantages. The advantage is, one of the advantages is, okay, yes, we can use this URL rewriting in a very simple manner when compared to hidden form fields. Okay, we can develop the query string in a very simple way. Okay, when compared to hidden form fields. But the disadvantages are, like, it may reach the maximum URL length if the number of parameters are more. It may reach the maximum URL length. Okay, let's consider, like, for this server, maximum URL length that is accepted is 5000 characters. And if there are 100 request parameters, then there is a chance of exceeding the maximum URL length. Okay, that's the problem. And second problem is, everything is displayed in the browser address bar, so it is very, very less secure. Okay, it is less secure even when compared to hidden form fields. Okay, not every user may know that, like, view page source will get the hidden form fields, but every user can see the URL, so every user can see the secure content. So URL rewriting is less secure when compared to hidden form fields. Just because everything is displayed in the browser address bar. And even it has a limitation that the URL size or the length of the URL will have a limit for any server. So if the number of parameters to be maintained in the session are more, this cannot be approached. This approach cannot be taken. Understand? So to overcome these kind of difficulties, it's a third way of managing the session is using cookies. Okay? The third way of session management is using cookies. And one more thing about the URL rewriting. Let's consider that. Now, how the form is submitted from login servlet to first servlet? What is the method that we use? Post. Now, let me use get. Okay, let me use get as a method of form submission from login servlet to first servlet and from first servlet to second servlet. And in the first servlet as well as second servlet, let me override doGet method. Understood? Understood? So, let me stop the server. Compile the application. Restart the server. So, now from login.html to login servlet is a post. So, now let me enter. Now from login.html to login servlet it is post request. Okay, so nothing is displayed in the browser. But now, how it should happen? Username and password values, first name and last name values should go to the server as request parameters through query string. Understood? Along with first name and last name, even username and password also should be submitted. So if you go next, are username and password listed in the browser address bar? We have rewritten the URL, right? We have rewritten the URL in such a way that the URL should contain even username and password fields. But is the URL contains, does the URL contains username password fields now? No. Now, let me enter mobile number. Email ID. Okay. Now, what are the request parameters available here in the browser address bar? Only mobile and email ID. Only mobile and email ID. Okay. Then in this case, is session maintained? In this case, is session management done? Or is session maintained? Yes or no? No, session is not maintained here just because username, password, first name, last name is not available here. But why? Why means? Let's consider like the URL that we are going to submit here is. Let's consider like we are in login servlet. From login servlet to first servlet, this is the URL that we are going to submit. Okay? But when we click on submit, okay, if the method of form submission is get, then the existing query string will be overridden by the latest query string. So what is the existing query string? So how the actual URL will go to the will hit the server means hello.first, first name equal to ampersand Russian. Actually, this is the URL that is supposed to be submitted to the browser. This is the URL that we have developed. But this URL is being overridden by this URL. Just because the get request, when it is submitted to the server, when we submit the form using the get method, okay, the URL will be rewritten by the web server. So the existing URL will be like this. But that URL will be modified like this. The existing URL will not be considered. This URL, which contains, okay, the first name and last name will be considered. Just because, if you see here, you go to login page, which is a post request. Let me go for. So, here Rajesh, Ravi, and 123 are submitted. It is a post request. So these are not displayed in the URL, but this form is a get request. So if you see the source, what is the action actually? The action is hello.first, username equal to Rajesh, ampersand username equal to Ravi, ampersand password equal to 123. Okay, and again the method is get. But since the method is get, okay, actually if you click on submit. This is the URL that is supposed to be displayed in the browser. Address bar. Okay? But when we click on submit, actually what happens is this URL will be converted into hello.first semicolon. This URL. Just because, since it is a get request will override the existing URL with the query string, with the request parameters. Understood? So, when we submit here, when we submit the form, only the first name and last name will go to the server. Please observe here, just first name and last name are going to the server, the username and password are not going. In the same way, mobile number, email ID are going to the server. Okay, mobile number and email ID are going to the server. Okay, but not the earlier values. So can we tell that we cannot manage the session using URL rewriting if the form submission is get? If I tell that we cannot manage the session, using URL rewriting if the method of form submission is get, Is it true or not? If I tell that we cannot manage the session or we cannot maintain the session using URL rewriting, if we submit the form using method get, is it true?
Yes.
So we cannot maintain the session using URL rewriting if the method of form submission is get. Just because if the method of form submission is get and we click on submit, the existing URL will be overridden with the request parameters. So we cannot do that if method equal to get. That is one of the limitations to URL rewriting. We cannot submit the form using method get. So URL rewriting will be used only for forms submitted using method post. URL rewriting will be used to maintain the session only for forms submitted using method post. URL rewriting will be used to maintain the session only when the forms are submitted, all the forms are submitted using method post. If at least one get method is there, if at least one form is there with method get, then session will not be maintained. If at least one form is there with method get, then the session will not be maintained. So if you use or if you want to use URL rewriting concept to manage the session or to maintain the session, then all the forms should be submitted using method post. If at least one form is there with method get, then URL rewriting cannot be used to maintain the session. Understood? So, the third approach is using cookies. We'll discuss that in the next class.